Grade 6 Math, number 2.6. Divide whole numbers and decimals by decimals. If you remember, the divisor is out here on the outside. That's the dividend, and that's the quotient up on top, the answer. And our decimal point is going to go directly above the dividend decimal point to the quotient. And that's where you know to put the decimal point in the answer, in the quotient. When the divisor is a decimal, you move the decimal point right. However many hops right it goes, you move the decimal point in the dividend the same amount of hops. And then you add zeros to the dividend if needed. So if you have 3/100ths and it's going to go into 147, there's no decimal point in the dividend. There's an invisible one here behind the 7 if it was just 147. So by moving the decimal point in the divisor 1-2 hops, we have to create a couple of place values for the dividend, don't we? 1-2 hops. So the decimal point will go up here for the answer in the quotient, and we had to put zeros in there to hold the place, didn't we? Why does this work? Well, the quotient stays the same as the dividend and divisor both increase by the same power of 10. So by moving it over, we're not going to change the quotient. It'll stay the same. So if we divide 6 by 3, we're going to get 2. And if we multiply the 6 and the 3 both by 10, it's still going to be 2. If we multiply the 6 and 3 by 100, the quotient's still going to be 2. But by multiplying them by those powers of 10, we move the decimal point, see? If we multiply it by 10, this is going to move one spot. So we multiply this by 10 to move it one spot. 2 and 5/10 goes into 47 and 5/10, just as if it was 475 divided by 25, see? As if they were whole numbers. 25 goes into 47. Well, if it was a 50, it could have gone in twice, but it's only a 47, so it's going to go in one time. We do the 1 times 25, we do our subtraction, and we get 22. It's the 5's turn to come down. 25 goes into 225. I did a little math on the side, which is how I like to do it instead of estimating. And I came up with 9. 25 times 9 is 225. So I put it up there. I already know it's 225 because I already did my math. And then I get a 0 remainder. See? And the answer is 19. Then I can multiply the quotient and the divisor to each other to check it. And if I come up with 475 as the product, I know I did it correctly because that's the amount of the dividend. See? You use the inverse operation to check it. If we have 5 and 75/100ths and we've got 17 and 25/100ths, we can move it 2 hops and move the divisor, the dividend 2 hops, and then just do our regular division as if it was 575 trying to fit into 1,725, see? We multiply the quotient times the divisor. If it comes out as the same number as the dividend, we know we did it correctly. So as I said in the beginning, sometimes we need to add a zero as a placeholder. If the dividend doesn't have enough digits for the decimal point, if we're dividing and our divisor is 14,000ths, we need to move it 3 hops to get it back here, the decimal point. So we're going to have to move it in the dividend 3 hops. And by doing that, the decimal point is going to go directly above here for the quotient, but we needed to put zeros in to hold those places. Because remember what I always say, in math, zeros have no value, they're just placeholders, and they're really good placeholders, aren't they? So essentially what happens is our division problem ends up becoming 37,800 divided by 14. See? We do our multiplication of the quotient times the divisor to check it. And if it comes out as the same amount as the dividend, we know we did it correctly. See? Just remember, if you have to, do a little math on the side to help you figure out how many times it'll go in, that's fine. And remember that if we got to here, and 98 minus 98 is 0, and we still had 2 zeros in the dividend, you don't really need to go any further. Just put zeros there, because 14 goes into 0 how many times? 0. And then we drop the other 0, how many times does 14 go into 0? 0. See? Because there's zeros down here and there's no numbers, we can just put zeros there, all right? So that's dividing whole numbers and decimals by decimals. I made a video, number 2.4a, that covered all the different types of decimal division, decimals to whole numbers to decimals to decimals, and it was an overview that you might want to take a look at if you haven't already seen it, okay? It shows you exactly what's happening when we divide, all right? See you next video. Bye.